This is a study in patients with relapsed refractory myeloma. So actually, we enrolled 90 patients, and they were uniformly treated with an ixazomib-based regimen, ixazomib-taldex. They received 8 cycles of induction therapy and then 1 year of ixazomib maintenance therapy, actually, which was very well tolerated, the maintenance therapy. One of the questions we raised, or the question which we raised in the poster which is presented now, is whether there are differences in outcome in patients with different constitution of the oral microbiome. So there's very little known about the oral microbiome in general and in myeloma in particular. So we collected mouse swabs at baseline. Actually, we collected them at each cycle, but what this presentation just shows the baseline diversity of the oral bacterial microbiome. And actually, 79 studies were then actually enrolled in the microbiome study. So the DNA was extracted from the mouse swabs, and the bacterial RNA was sequenced. And one of the measure of a healthy microbiome is the diversity. So you need to have a very if you have a high diversity, it's generally considered to be healthy. And when we looked at the outcome, so patients with a higher diversity of the oral microbiome at the villus level, they had a significantly longer progression-free survival. And patients with the diversity of the oral microbiome and progression-free survival was particularly marked in those with the highest, longest progression-free survival. So the higher the diversity, the better the progression-free survival. It's a general statistical association. And what was also interesting is patients with progressive disease had a reduced diversity of the microbiome. So in other words, you need to have a high diversity in order to have a high likelihood for better progression-free survival. And there are very interesting studies which have been done by Calcinotto and Lee Berxagel. So they looked at the microbiome in myeloma-bearing mice, and what they found is that when you all, so these mice have progressive myeloma, and when you alter the microbiome by antibiotic treatment, you may improve the outcome of these mice. And this refers us, this reminds us to what we do in general, for instance, in mouth lymphoma. In very early mouth lymphoma, you can cure patients by eliminating Helicobacter by antibiotic therapy. And in heavy chain disease, which is a plasma cell disorder affecting the gastrointestinal tract, when you use in early stages antibiotic therapy, you can improve the outcome. So in the near future, possibly, it may be thinkable that in certain situations, modification of the microbiome may be used in order to improve the outcome of the disease of myeloma. You can think about stool transplantation, you can think about antibiotic treatment in certain instances, and also you can think about using specific bacterial species to impact on the constitution of the microbiome. These are initial studies, and I'm sure many groups will look at this in greater detail. At this time, we can say the composition is associated of the microbiome, of the oral microbiome, is associated with progression-free survival. The greater the diversity, the better the outcome in our patients.